and gentlemen, as you can see right now, it is 9:04 in the morning on a Sunday. Last night, the Red Sox won off of a walk-off home run from Jared Saltamacchia, and the Celtics won, so it was a long night. But today, I gotta go back to work, and I'm very pleased to bring you along with me as I give you an inside look at a day in the life of a Hawker at Fenway Park. So whenever you go out with Boston baseball, you have to be prepared. This is the arsenal of stuff. It always starts with, of course, the Boston baseball t-shirt featuring none other than Sylvester on the back there. I've been wearing this little headband lately. I don't know why. Kind of goes with the shirt. Makes me feel a bit more coordinated, I would say. If that makes any sense. Red Sox wristbands, just to keep the sweat off my brow as I'm slinging $3 programs out at Fenway Park. The buttons, so the people know exactly what they're paying. Two is always good. And this is something I recently started bringing out. This is my little speaker. Sometimes I get at a spot where I can plug in my phone and play some music. Add a couple Gatorades and a pair of shades, which I am not able to find at the moment. And you have a full-on survival kit for being a Hawker for Boston baseball at Fenway Park.
I got started with Boston baseball about 2 years ago in the summer of 2010. I came over in late May from where I'm from in Montana. I didn't have a job. I wanted to come out to Boston to take care of some stuff going on with an ex-girlfriend, and I happened to know like nothing about Boston at all. I went on Craigslist. I typed in Red Sox, Fenway Park, you know, Celtics. I found an ad for Boston Baseball Magazine. They said they were hiring hawkers. I didn't know what a hawker was. And I sent a reply just asking about it, and Mike went over the details of the job, told me, you know, once I got out to Boston to come check it out, he'd give me a shot and see how things went. I did okay my first couple days there and ended up sticking out the whole season. Here I am today, another beautiful Sunday in Boston, driving down Storrow Drive, getting ready to go sell as the Red Sox take on the Tampa Bay Rays today. We have a great crew of guys that work at Fenway for Boston Baseball Magazine. We have Sylvester, or Sly, as he is known to pretty much everybody. There is Chooch, who's also a veteran. He's been around for a long time. There's John. He's been around for a while as well. John is a staple at Fenway Park, also a top three seller. There's Jay. We call him Zach Morris. There's Coolidge. Coolidge is a second generation seller, from what I've been told. And then there's Ilya.
In Soviet Russia, the program buys you.
If you had to describe Ilya in one word, what would it be?
Goofy.
I think he landed in an egg, sort of like Mork. That's what I think happened to Ilya. He's definitely the poster boy for Chernobyl and what radiation does to the human brain, because that's him.
Somebody calm him out.
Get away.
Somebody calm him out.
Get away from him.
He uses his ability to be annoying and sort of worm his way under people's skin to get them to buy shit somehow.
You say Red Sox?
Yeah.
More like Red Sucks.
So right now it's about time to stop by 7-Eleven, get myself some Gatorades for hydration, and then go to work. So let's go to work. Going on? Top of the morning.
Get a good sleep last night?
Not really.
Yeah.
I drank a lot in the Celtics one. Gatorade, weapon of choice. For me, at least.
I prefer blue myself, but you know.
John's got the blue.
Yes. I'm minus low calorie.
Yep. Watch your figure. So every day we get a promo item to put with the programs. Today it looks like we've got Yankees, Red Sox, scorebook postcards. Always a hot item, right? Jay's method of pre-shift fuel. What are you eating there, Jay?
Sausage biscuit with a whole slab of jack cheese in there, and then I nuke it. 30 seconds, bam.
Man, friggin' Emeril Lagasse over here at Boston Baseball.
Two at a time.
Double fisted. So this is what we do before every shift. We gather in this little garage, suit up,
got promo items, pencils, everyone's got their little apron. Everyone's sipping on their fuels, their hydration. You can see there's lines of Powerades and things like that. Lemon's stacking up crates here. And this is the pre-shift preparations. And there's the legend over there.
Like, these shirts are not fat man friendly.
So
man, a double X.
They're getting restless. It's about that time. We're officially on shift. I'm at gate D today. Splitting it with Lizzie here. Jim, our friend, always has to stack our crates right here.
I'm hoping to be here much more during the summer.
So now it's time to go out and sell some goddamn programs.
Every day I'm hustling. 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 Every day I'm. Every day I'm. Every day I'm hustling.
Who you suckers think you're tripping with? Yes, I'm the boss. 745, white on white, that's Rick Ross. I keep them wide, I keep them long, I keep them fat. I keep them coming back, we keep them coming back. I'm in the distribution, I'm like Atlantic. I got them pretty things flying across the Atlantic. I know Pablo.
Front guard, front man, lineup. Green obvious here. All the names, all the numbers. Dirty about the 3 bucks.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how do you think sales were today?
7.5.
Not too sure. How'd you do today, Ilya?
It was beyond atrocious, man.
So the shift is done. Everyone's in here counting now. Once everyone gets in, it gets a little crazy, kind of maddening, but everyone counts out their money. They count out with Mike, and then Mike updates the standings and pays us out. And that's a day in the life of a Boston baseball hawker. Godspeed.